shot.
Here, drink some of this.
Have a shot.
The first time you do it, you put yourself at risk because it takes a toll.
I drank to experiment and also to relieve stress.
There's always a reason to do it. I'm stressed. I don't like my parents.
Yeah. Everyone that goes to public school like doesn't want to see what you need. You just want to fit in and you just want to try that out. Why is everybody else doing it? There must be something, you know, great about it.
Hello, my name is Barry Keene. We now have a 40-year window of information regarding alcohol and marijuana. One in four students entering college is either an adult child of an alcoholic or an adult child of a substance abuser. If I start smoking marijuana or alcohol at 14 years old or younger, I stand a very good chance of developing a substance abuse problem by the time I'm 20 years old.
I was 14 years old when I tried weed with my friends.
She had done it before I did, but she showed me and she said it was okay to do it and she liked it. I tried it.
It was just a new feeling that I needed to explore.
Yeah, my parents think I'm sleeping at your house.
Yeah, I'm just jumping in the shower.
Okay, bye.
Of the gifted young actor Heath Ledger by accidental overdose of a toxic combination of prescription pills was, well, that was tragic in and of itself. It was also a parent's nightmare come to life because more teenagers are abusing prescription drugs than ever before. Get this, according to the White House Office of National Drug Control Policy, abuse of prescription and over-the-counter drugs is now epidemic. Nearly 700,000 people aged 12 to 17 reported abusing prescription drugs in the past month.
There is a solution. 3 years ago, denial was developed to explain tobacco, alcohol, marijuana, and other substances to 8 to 14-year-olds. Denial was designed to open the door of communication between parents and their teens and preteens.
Smoking weed hurts more than just you.
Feel so much, but cannot say a word. Though we are screaming inside, oh, it can't be heard. And I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let you.
Business is off, man. Sales are down. Seems like half my customers, they don't even need me anymore, you know? I mean, they're getting high for free out of the medicine cabinets. How am I supposed to compete with that? Got kids? Well, next time something goes south with your kids, don't look at me, man. Ain't my problem. I didn't do it.
Teens don't need a drug dealer to get
I
high.
Wish I did.
Safeguard your prescriptions. Safeguard your teens.
I started thinking if I only drank on the weekends, I wouldn't get addicted to drinking.
But I don't think I'll get addicted, though. Like, or to any type of drug.
In the beginning, I felt like I was controlling it, but after that, it got out of control. Like, as I said before, I was high for 6 months.
It was every day. I'd be back there in the alley smoking weed with everybody else.
I drank so much that I started throwing up my stomach lining.
My health deteriorated. I've lost homes. I've never been able to hold a job. I've lived on the streets.
I ended up losing my scholarship in college.
Everything I wanted to be just went down the drain.
I could justify using in order to enjoy myself and other things.
They opened the door for us and she was dead on the bed with the needle in her arm.
Gave him a shot of adrenaline to his heart, flatlined him, killed him right there.
But when it's all over, only person has pain in the past.